Our birth was a noisy time. Sawing, groaning, cracking, and shaving. Hands gripped us, moved us, and shaped us. And then there was silence again. We sat on the shelf, two non-identical twins, and we waited for the season to have its way. After months of patience, the noise began again. Cutting, shaving, stitching and nailing, and we were given our skin. Painted leather and clever stitches, a proud silence fell. We were almost ready. We sat back on the shelf and waited for life to come. As our days in the world passed by, our shapes changed. We moulded to the life we carried, and we moulded the way that the life moved. As we trudged through mud, fended off frozen ground and the midday blaze, sweat, blisters, sun and rain, the seasons had its way. But sometimes music played, and steps that were flat and heavy became nimble. Heels left the ground, and the tapping and knocking of life rang in time. The ground became a drum, and we played until blisters, aches, and sweat filled our bellies. The drumming became slower, the steps less nimble, the balance less certain. And in a flash, the dance was over. A silence fell, the seasons had their way. And we could have held another life, but no life came. New lives were wooed by other things, rubber soles and plastic skin, seconds to make and cheap to replace, one in each color and a spare pair just in case. So we waited. Until somebody found us. They saw our bruises and our scars, and they thought maybe we told a story. They thought maybe we had a message. Maybe we just had something to say.
Wisdom's within.
in our final home, with hard skin and brittle souls, no skin can brush against our own. Catalogues and cotton gloves preserve the wood that sticks to us. Glass doors to keep the weather out, inquisitive fingers go without. The seasons cannot have their way, so frozen out of time, we wait, reminders of a life that kept us, remembering the time that left us.